median of the parkway and hit by two more vehicles.
Matt, tonight, a major college chain based right here in Pittsburgh is accused of cheating taxpayers out of more than $1 billion. The whistleblower lawsuit targets EDMC, parent company of the art institutes. Investigative reporter Paul Van Osdahl is live in the newsroom with this story. Paul.
Wendy, this lawsuit against EDMC was filed under the Federal False Claims Act. It alleges the college chain fraudulently obtained millions of dollars in student loan money. It also accuses the company of exploiting veterans to get even more taxpayer dollars under questionable means. Garland Ritchie of McKeesport is a combat veteran who served in Iraq, including a stint doing security for then Defense Secretary Donald Rumsfeld. When he came home, he got a job with EDMC, trying to get active duty soldiers and veterans to enroll in their online programs. He was good at it.
Oh, highly successful, because I could make a report, I could talk their language.
Government rules say EDMC and other schools can get no more than 90% of their funds from taxpayer-funded student loans. But soldiers and veterans paying for school under the GI Bill do not count against that total, making them attractive for schools.
They're easy targets.
Even though soldiers and veterans do not need government loans, the lawsuit says EDMC pushed them.
They were thinking it was just extra money from the government, you know, because it wasn't fully explained to them that they had to repay that student loan that they didn't necessarily have to take out.
Even more troubling to Ritchie, he says EDMC encouraged soldiers to enroll in school even as they were being deployed to combat.
And they're thinking that they can attend school, and we're telling them things like, well, it's a great way to get the war off your mind. You don't get war off your mind. You know, when you wake up to a shell coming into your base.
Ritchie says he tried to push back at EDMC, but he lost his job. The lawsuit says EDMC's deceptive sales tactics took a big toll.
They are defrauding the federal government, the taxpayers, and the students.
In a statement, an EDMC spokesman says they believe the suit is without merit and they will defend themselves. Ritchie says he hopes the lawsuit forces changes at the school.
Sometimes the only way that you can get a true apology is through somebody's bank, you know, through their wallet.
EDMC is currently facing two other whistleblower lawsuits that have made similar allegations. The company is also being investigated by 14 state attorneys general. In the newsroom, Paul Van Osdahl, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.
Paul, thank you. Less than a month now until big changes coming for Highmark and UPMC. And now the state's actually